weeks when you just think, oh, can I breathe today? Anyway, we're doing okay. I'm doing much better than I was. So. But it is good to be here. It's one of the things, you know, when you're sick, you have no language, you wish you could be with people. And that's why we're here. We won't have them by anything like that. But we're continuing in the series that I've been talking about, all through the season after Epiphany. And one more Sunday, which is Transfiguration, which is next week. And that winds up our whole season after Epiphany. But what I've been talking about is walking with Jesus. It sounds so easy to do, to walk with Jesus on a daily basis. But throughout this time that I've been talking is, how are we walking with Jesus? How is it that we're looking at sharing and being Christ followers? And there are many different ways we're looking at it. With faith, with love, with hope. And now today we're saying, in holiness. Holy. Being holy. It's not an easy definition, but it's something connected to God or dedicated, consecrated, set aside for a specific purpose. We say a place of worship is holy. It has been set aside because that's where God shows up. We're supposed to. At least only when we do, when we experience God. As Christians, we're pursuing what it means to be holy in a world, but what's difficult is that there's so much unholiness in the world. We can walk down the street, and evidence for this is everywhere. Think about walking down the street where you live. Where is God in the relationships of people, amongst people and children, and with respect to those who are in need of assistance?
To go against the flow
called sometime to wonder about us as Christians. Are we going against the flow because the world is so unholy? Going against the flow just so that we can walk in holiness. When we walk with Jesus, we have that journey to continue on, to then try to carry on, because we're called to have that faith within us, to live a holy life, to pursue holiness without which no one will see the Lord. If we don't pursue holiness, how are we going to know who God is? We won't recognize Him. In order to see our spawning grounds, which we might want to even call heaven, that is going back to where we came from God and back to God, we need to live an absolute resolve that we are seeking God day to day, moment to moment, and living a holy, wonderful life with God. Leviticus 19 describes many laws by which the people of Israel were to live by and follow. Not the laws that we learned in Exodus 20, the Ten Commandments, but the everyday kind of laws. That is, when you're cleaning off a field or you're harvesting a crop, leave some for the poor people and those who are not from the area. That means leave some of the grain, leave some of the grapes. Well, we're not doing that much here. We don't do that kind of harvesting. But the idea is to give some to help others. But the idea is there. To live a holy life means leave a little bit for somebody else. Those laws reflect from what and how to eat, to reap the harvest, leaving some things to the poor, to helping those who are deaf or blind, and for others in need, as well as caring for others above what you would normally do. These were the laws God gave the people of Israel in order that they could be holy, to become like Him. Jesus builds upon those laws and says, and He tells the people who are doing a sermon on the mountain, and says, do more of them. He says, love your neighbors, yes, but love and pray also for your enemies. When you come into a disagreement, don't just stand there and get what you get. Put the other one out there too. Because when you have that difficult time, it's knowing that you are standing up for God. He says, if someone wants to take your tunic, give them the culture they need or need you. Or go that extra mile. Do that little extra for them. We've heard of the pay it forward campaigns in many years. You know, the latest thing is to pay for somebody's meal in a drive-thru. That's not the whole thing, but that's a part of it. You're sharing a little bit more. But paying it forward means also to give a little bit more of yourself. It means put a little bit more effort into it. Do something extra for someone else. So that there's no power struggle. So that there is power that's shared and held mutually. So that it enables relationships to be stronger than any judgment can be. So that there can be more compassion than guilt. And this new law is the law of community and love. If everybody gave an extra bit, amazing understanding would be. This past week, Presbyterian met, we learned a little bit more about poverty. The level of poverty in the city of Windsor is more than I had ever thought. Not just talking stats and people going to downtown missions. It's not all it is. It's people living day to day under the poverty line. And we just think, well, what can we do about it? How can we share? Giving a little more, sharing a little more. But this new law of sharing and giving, that's what Jesus said, this is not an easy thing to do. It's difficult. It's going to be dangerous to say, why bother? What difference will it make? But it does make a difference. Not only to the person who might receive, but to you who give as well. But it is still difficult. But think about it. When you're in a disagreement with someone, you want to be sure to get your point across in a strong way. You want to be heard. But what if you let the other person speak fully? And then hear what they actually share. Maybe you're having a change of heart, change of thought. walk around the mall and say hi to everybody. It's really different because we go, what's wrong with that person? Maybe we should start here in church. There are people here who don't know each other's names. We might sit on the cross from different places, but there are still people who don't know what your backgrounds are. Challenging you to say hello to someone you know of but not spoken of before. We know about each other, but remember one of the things about it is we're almost families coming together. At least that's what we're believing. We're all standing, swimming backwards, back up to the spawning grounds to which God calls us all again. It's really good to know who's living with us. Who is it that's God calling us to be and to become? Walking a little bit more with God. Jesus says, if someone forces you to go 1 mile, that is under pressure and being pushed. Go the extra mile with them. They need your support. How often do you sit and talk with someone and just say, oh, I gotta go now, gotta go. Even when you're on telephone, oh, sorry, something else is coming up. If you take the extra 2 minutes, what difference does it make? I talk from my own experience and this and say, oh, yeah, I have to do something right now. I just say, no, I need to talk to this person now. Person is revealing something that's important to them. Taking that extra couple of minutes makes a difference in someone else's life. If you're going to go the extra mile, it means more, do more than what is expected of you. You like this when it comes to customer service? Because that's what you remember. You remember the person who served you and was pleasant and friendly and nice, and she deserved the tip that you gave her. But if someone just throws them a bit at you, you don't want to go out there. Customer service makes a difference. And that's the same thing as when we welcome each other in the name of Christ. How are we receiving each other? How are we sharing with one another? How are we being holy in God's sight with one another? And the difference will be how did that person make you feel? In Jesus' time, to walk an extra mile took a lot of time, effort, and an understanding of support from one person to another. The person was traveling from point A to point B and then really had to go on to point C. Jesus made a difference. He said, go to point C, help them carry the load. If you were traveling and your companions take you longer than necessary, this meant you would be safe on the road. You would not be alone, potentially afraid of animals and robbers. You are often seen as a caring and compassionate person whose choices went beyond oneself. And that's what it means to be holy, doing that extra little bit. Not just enough, or what appears to be good enough. Our hearts and minds and wills are where holiness exists, and this can be easily destroyed. It's our desire, our emotion and attitude, our judgments and reasoning, our relationships, our speech, past and memories, and all the use of our media makes a difference in what we choose to live a holy life. But what do we do to keep us walking with Jesus in holiness? We need to let the Spirit guide us and empower us to take another step, to move along. We need to decide each day to be holy, to give that day to God. How many woke up this morning and other than watching the hockey and just said, this is your day, God, what do you want me to do in it? I don't know how many people really God wanted to watch the hockey, I don't know. But one of the things is, what did you do? Say, God, this is your day, what do you want me to do for you in this day? And start each day that way. God made it, you fill it. To be aware of temptations when they come and guard your heart. You're going to get tempted by so many different things in life every moment. It's interesting to be able to go downstairs, turn the TV on and watch this, or go upstairs on your computer and live stream everything. The choices are there. You know, they get ready to go to church today. But what is it that calls you to do something? The temptations are there. How do you become holy? Continue to strive to be holy in God's sight. To be aware of your thoughts and live a life of accountability. Who are you accountable to? is up to us. Are you ready to continue your swim upstream? Or are you just ready just to give a little bit of effort? The bears are watching. And the birds. Watch out for the rocks. All those things that can take us away from God. Let's walk with Jesus in holiness, knowing that one day we will be with Him forever. And that is what we should be hoping for and giving thanks for and smiling about, because we know one day we will be with Christ. Thanks be to God. Let us pray. Wonderful and holy God, we praise You and we thank You for our ability to walk with Jesus in holiness. Help us to live holy lives. Transform us as we continue to grow in life.